What's up guys, it's Roostick. Today I'm going to be doing an action breakdown of the Venom trailer. If you haven't seen it yet, make sure to go check it out in the description. Actually, I auditioned for this movie 6 months ago, but I didn't get it. I do know a couple of the people that worked on the movie, but I don't know anything about it. I'm going to play it and I'm going to break it down for you how I think they did it. So let's do this. Okay, so first stunt that we have is actually this girl in the beginning of the trailer, and she breaks out of this room and tackles Tom Hardy. Let's see what that looks like. Boom. All right, now it looks like a simple thing, but if you look at it again in slow motion, you can see that they're literally airborne sideways and not really making contact. So that makes me believe that they're on wires for this part. And then also, if you watch when they land, they slide a little bit. That little slide is usually what happens when you're on wire as well. Next, we have Tom Hardy in his bathroom, whipped back into a bathtub. So pretty simple, straightforward. I think that Tom was on a little baby wire pull for this one, gets pulled back, and then they put the stunt double in for the top-down shot. That's a pretty nice hit. All right, so next we have a pretty cool sequence. So here we see Venom's character take out a bunch of bad guys by mixing practical stunts with VFX, which actually fits Venom's character really well. Anytime I see people mixing practical physics with some CGI, I think that looks the best. So this one right here, he is set up and he gets pulled on a wire through this window, and they add a CGI Venom hand. Boom. Part two of this wire gag is Tom Hardy lifting a guy in the air. This is pretty straightforward. I'm pretty sure they had a wire off camera up this way. This particular wire pull is very interesting, really fun to do. So you see this guy get punched in the face and then thrown sideways and kind of land almost like at a 45 upside down. Now, if you look at it in slow motion, it's two cuts. You have him getting punched, then you cut out of it, and you have this guy ready to go. So he has a vest on underneath. He is picked from about right here because that's where his center of gravity is. That way he can spin in this axis sideways. Boom, into the wall. All right, so this last part right here, Venom shoots out backwards. The guy gets flown into a wall. This was actually two wire pulls. The first one over here, when he lands, going backwards like that. You can't really do that naturally without looking like you're jumping. And right here. So right here you have the guy probably start over here. Now he was picked and going right into this wall. Little baby wire pull, but it looks amazing. So moving on, now we have one of the coolest parts of the trailer. Venom takes out two cars and they start flying behind him. Let me just tell you, the people that are coordinating this movie are legends in the business. So I can tell you with 95% certainty that they did this practically. So they have shot one, the camera in front of the bike. This would be Tom Hardy's double with a bunch of dots on his face so they can replace his face later. And in this one right here, when they cut in, you can see the stunt double's face is dark, so you can't tell that's Tom anymore. And then these cars are taking a massive wreck, and that would have been really nasty. Now we have Tom Hardy breaking through a tree. You can see it's built up of little pieces, and you see the dust here for effect. And then you have this little jump right here on the razor. You can see how the razor compresses as it lands. That's how you could tell that was a real jump. Next we have getting ambushed and jumping out of a window. Pretty simple, two shots, one going straight from the back as Tom Hardy jumps through the window. And I'm pretty sure this would be made on like a stage, and you could just go through here and jump onto a pad. And then this next one, at first I thought was green screen, but once I went through frame by frame, I think that this is actually what's called a descender. You have your vest on, you get picked from about up here. You have a controlled descent all the way down. Check it out, boom, boom. All right, so next we got this fun little clip. You can tell that the force is coming from the middle, and this is where like the little details of filmmaking come into play. So you can see the people on the outside of the circle, further away from the invisible energy blast, they just take their own reactions and fall. But the people in the middle, you can see how much they travel. We are down to the last one. Tom Hardy running away from the car, doing a wheelie, jumping. He gets away from his motorcycle. Venom brings it back, he lands. Let's break it down. First shot, stunt double is driving away from a car. Next you have Tom Hardy's face starting to do wheelie, stunt double with face replacement. Then you have another shot from the side launching into the air. Then you have Tom Hardy's face flying away from the motorcycle. Now this would have been done in a green screen studio. Both the bike and Tom were put on wires. Then you have the side scrolling shot, which I would guarantee you is actually VFX. So this house in front is probably fake. This right here is probably a drone shot. And this right here are all CGI. And then you go back to the shot of Venom grabbing the bike, Tom getting closer to it. You have a top-down shot, which I'm still sure is a green screen shot, and then you have the shot landing. Now this last shot, you can kind of tell by the shadows that go through here, like the little detail of the shadow that goes through another shadow makes it realistic. And you can kind of tell by the way the bike lands that it's actually there, but I'm pretty sure they would have had whatever ramp they used over here, and they would have just like painted it out, because you can see the sky is all black here. Let's watch that one more time. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 shots to make that work. When it's put together, it flows really well. All right, guys, so that was my action breakdown. I haven't told anybody this, but I actually auditioned for this movie about 6 months ago. I didn't get it, but I've just been watching it develop behind the scenes, and they're really smart filmmakers. Spider-Man was my favorite superhero growing up, and the Marvel movies were okay, but I thought they were a little bit campy. This looks like a Dark Knight style of movie, but like with Venom. I'm really excited about the story. I'm really excited to see this movie. Hopefully you enjoyed this. Let me know in the comments if you want to see another breakdown of another action movie or action trailer. And let me know what you think. Thanks guys for watching. I'll see you in the next video.